study that was done in Hyderabad 6 months ago by Helping Hand Foundation has measured the pollution rates at 6 major intersections, and then they surveyed people who live in the surrounding area of 3 to 4 kilometers. There is a high incidence of high blood pressure, there is a high incidence of diabetes in the areas which are highly polluted.
Yes.
So urbanization comes, unless it is planned, it has got a health burden. For example, Karunagaru has said that India is gaining the reputation as the accident capital of the world, and wonderful, with due respect to my good friend from Telangana, G.D. Metla has got the reputation as the most noisiest city, noisiest township in India.
Yes.
That is a distinction that you don't want to covet for. Now, coming to this, what is happening with, as Dr. Karunagaru has suggested, these non-communicable diseases are growing by leaps and bounds in your own neighborhood.
Yes.
Blood pressure, diabetes, cholesterol, cancer, etc. And there is always an interaction between genetics, for over which you have no control, and environment, over which you have some control.
Yes.
And where the health professionals have to do is, there is some point of contact where this burden can be decreased by proper planning. Studies and studies and studies have shown for last 100 years, slum areas, which are mostly in the cities. Slums means you think of city, not village.
Mm.
The highest incidence of cardiovascular disease burden is the slum areas,
yes,
because they have no access to medical care.
Yeah.
And we don't provide medical care. Everybody has to go to Usmania, stand in the line. They go to Gandhi, stand in the line. Go to NIMS, stand in the line. That is not going to work. Usmania was built by Nizam for 2 lakh individuals. When Nizam gave Hyderabad to government of India, he said, I am giving you a beautiful city that will take care of 2 lakh individuals. 2 lakh is gone. So everything has to be decentralized. There should be 100 Usmania clinics in the city. There should be 100 Gandhi clinics in the city.
Yes.
There should be 200 NIMS clinics in the city, where you decentralize.
Mm.
You must, unless you decentralize, everybody wants to go there, and actually some of them may actually die before they go there.
Yeah.
So I think India now is not the India 48 of what Nizam has given to Hyderabad. Everything has to be decentralized. There's no point why everybody has to go to Nilofer, why everybody has to go to government maternity hospital. It should be in the neighborhood. So one of the solutions should be to decentralize, if possible, if there is a point of contact. But there's no point of contact because the health minister is not available. IAS secretaries for health keep on changing. I sat with them before when I came. I worked with them, and then they are transferred from health to something else. So this is what is happening. And the other thing I want to mention, then I'll close. Whenever there are slums, there are limited opportunities for children. And it has been said that people who live in the slums, many of the children don't make it till age 5.
Yes.
Mark my word. Many of the children living in slums don't make it to age 5. And this is terrible. And slums, we have to respect slums. I'm not being we have to take Mother Teresa approach and respect it. Tremendous anger, tremendous agitation, and tremendous violence happens in slums because there's no space. There's no space on the top, raining, there's no space to protect them from the heat, and water is flooding. So what I'm trying to say is, urban development is a concept that will continue to grow. But unless it is designed with public health experts, where you keep the health of the individual as a priority in this building process, a skyscraper has no meaning if there's nobody there who can go there and help the people there. So my comment will be, the non-communicable diseases Karunagaru has mentioned have gone. It will continue to grow worse along with urbanization. When they say the urban-rural divide, it happens not because of the skyscraper, because the poor health, the health of our citizens is tremendously impaired if there's no simultaneous planning and access to healthcare delivery. Those are my remarks.